So now that we've connected to our vehicle, we can go ahead and select the car software on our environment screen here, since we will be working with automotive. Remember, we are working with our 2013 F-150. Now it opens it up into a few categories. We have light commercial vehicles, passenger cars, and supercar. However, supercar is an additional package. We'll make the passenger car selection and scroll through the list and look for Ford, as we're working with that F-150. We'll go ahead and make that selection, and then we'll have to scroll down to this list and find our correct model, which is our 2013 Ford F-150. Now that we have found it, we can make that selection, or we can go to the Ford and click the automatic VIN search, and it'll look up our proper model via the VIN number. So we'll go ahead and do that now. Now that the VIN scan is completed, we can see our VIN numbers at the top, and now we can go ahead and work on getting connected. We have two options to get connected here. We have the global system scan, or we can get connected directly by modules, and here is the list of modules and the diagnosis by system. And these are all modules that could possibly be on the vehicle. If you're unsure of what modules are on the vehicle, we can go ahead and perform that system scan. But in the case you knew exactly what you're working with, you could select a module such as body computer and go ahead and click start to get connected that way. But say we're unsure what we're working with, we can go ahead and go back up to the top and perform our system scan to see what modules we can communicate with on the vehicle. When you click system scan, it'll bring up your connection information, what connector, and the connector location. If you need a little further assistance, you can watch the film strip and it'll show you the port location. We need to ensure the key is in the run position and click the check mark, and we'll give it a moment to do its system scan. It is trying to communicate with all possible modules that could be on the vehicle, so it may take a moment here. Once it completes, it'll bring us to our system scan here, and then we have our list of modules with an icon next to each module. The red icon will indicate that we are not communicating with that module, or that module is not on the vehicle. A green icon indicates we are communicating with that vehicle, however there are no fault codes within it. And the yellow icon indicates that we are communicating and there are fault codes within that module. The DTC detected tab will give you a brief overview of the fault codes within each module, if there are any. And then now you can double click on a module if you choose to get connected to that module. And we will do so here. We'll go ahead and hit confirm. Instrument panel is on. So now that we've gotten connected to the body control module, this is the screen it'll bring us to. Here we'll start on the faults tab. Here we'll have your list of faults within this module. Now, if you make the proper repair, you can come down to the bottom and use this eraser to clear the codes. You can click on this floppy disk icon to save the list, or you can click on the printer icon here to print off this list if you were to choose. Next is the Ecu Info tab, and within this tab you can find information about the ECU. However, nothing can be changed within this tab. Next we have our Activations tab. Our Activations tab is going to have all the tests that we can perform on this vehicle through the module. Now you can see we have a full list of tests here. What tests you can perform on the vehicle are dependent upon manufacturer, module, and what the vehicle is equipped with. They're not going to be the same across the board, so just keep that in mind. Next, we're going to go into our settings tab. Our settings tab is going to be any parameter changes or adjustments that we can make. They will all be found in the settings tab. This again is specific to manufacturer, module, and what the vehicle is equipped with. Next, we're getting to the parameters tab. Now we have our parameters tab. We can look through our parameters tab here and see the different live values that we can view through the ECM on our vehicle today. It's a long list of parameters, what parameters you can view are dependent upon the manufacturer and module and what the vehicle is equipped with. Let me take a quick peek of what we're working with here today. Now, there's a long list of parameters to scroll through, especially if you're trying to compare values. So we do have the filter function of our parameters down here at the bottom. And with this filter button, you can choose what you'd like to view in the parameters tab. That way it'll narrow that list down for you. Now we're going to go ahead and disconnect and show a different way to get connected to the module. So we just got connected to our body control module via the system scan. Now we're going to get directly connected to that module through our diagnosis by system. So we'll go ahead to our body computer here and we'll get connected directly to that body control module. So we'll open this up just so you can see that we're getting connected and the layout is the same. It's just two different ways to get connected. Go ahead and give it a minute to connect. Now that we're connected, you can see we start off on our faults tab, and we're going to run through these tabs real quickly, and we can see it's just the same module, and it's going to be the same information within it. Like I said, it is just two ways to get connected to the same module. We went through those two different ways to get connected to the modules, just so you know that there's multiple ways to get connected to the module. I suggest a system scan if it's the first time you're connected to the vehicle and have no idea what modules you're working with. However, if you know exactly which modules you're working with, you can get connected directly. Here we have returned to the diagnosis screen. Here you can make any new selections if you're getting connected to a different vehicle. And that about wraps it up for today's video uncovering the car side of the TEXA software. Thank you all for tuning in today with these laptops and our TEXA car videos. Thank you.